Okay, hello cloud gurus, how y'all doing? I'm Scott Pletcher, and this week on AWS This Week, AMIs get aliases, IoT users enjoy a 90% price reduction, S3 batch operations now support object locking, and we unveil the guru of the week. First and foremost, I do want to remind you that the AWS Summits Online are happening next week on May 13th for the US, Canada, Australia, New Zealand, Korea, India, and Southeast Asia. Now, registration is free, and we've included a link down below for your linking convenience. We, of course, will be in attendance to monitor all the sorted details and report back next week on our favorite items. Hey, trigger warning folks, what do we call those EC2 machine images in AWS? AMIs, that's right, I said it, AMIs, ha ha ha! This week, AWS announced that EC2 now supports custom identifiers to reference AMIs, or AMIs as most sensible people call them. Finally, you can give your AMIs a reasonable name to allow for easier lookup. Instead of having to remember AMI 9,265,000XY123, you can now create an alias like My Precious AMI and reference that when launching instances. It uses the AWS System Manager Parameter Store to hold those aliases and is a pretty clever solution to something that was long overdue. Who's ready for some 5G? I know I am, and it surely is hyping up the Internet of Things talk with all that bandwidth and low latency. I mean, who doesn't need millisecond response time from their connected coffee maker? Well, AWS has just provided another reason to connect even more inanimate objects to the wide world of the Internet by reducing the cost to manage those by 90%. AWS IoT Device Management makes it easy to securely register, organize, monitor, and remotely manage IoT devices at scale. You'll now be paying a mere 0.3 cents per remote action for the first 250,000 remote actions per month against your IoT devices. We all love our data, and sometimes we have to lock it down for the long term, such as in the case of legal holds or regulatory requirements. S3 object locking is one of my favorite ways to do this, and it protects objects from being overwritten or deleted, ensuring that they're going to remain immutable for as long as the S3 object lock is applied. AWS recently announced that now we can enable object locking on millions of objects using S3 batch operations. S3 batch operations, as the name implies, helps you with bulk actions against stuff in S3. Previously, if you wanted to lock down objects in S3, you would have had to do it manually or write a script to iterate through all the objects. And now on to the guru of the week. What the deuce? Well, we seem to have a power outage here at the Pletcher compound. And while we do have redundant power, it is configured to prioritize the supply to my bank of AWS Outpost racks that I keep in the garage. Fear not, my friends, all I have to do is press this little Amazon Dash button to notify our ACG family that I could use some help.
Well, hello there, cloud gurus. My name is Musa Khalid, and I'm an AWS training architect at Linux Academy, now part of AWS Guru, better together.
How you going, man?
I'm doing great, man. Just trying to keep up with the technology. Working out a little bit, at times, you're going to be able to see some muscle.
Hey, look, I've run into some technical difficulties. Do you think you can take us on out with the Guru of the Week?
It's going to be my honor to take you guys through the rest of the updates.
Appreciate it.
Weighing in at 0 pounds, because they must surely live on the cloud, I present to you Dharwani Sandaria. Well done, Dharwani. The cloud is definitely strong with this one. Be on the lookout for the swag pack on its way to you from ACG. And you've also been entered into the draw for reInvent 2020. Hopefully it still goes through, fingers crossed, so that you can come down there and meet all the cloud gurus and headbang to the tune of AWS rocking the world. This, my friends, has been AWS This Week.